बी रेडी। 5 सेकेंड्स। स्टार्ट। इट इज अनफॉर्चुनेट दैट द अपील मेड बाय ऑनरेबल द होम मिनिस्टर दैट दिस बिल शुड बी डिस्कस्ड इन ए प्रैक्टिकल मैनर टेकिंग इन टू कंसिडरेशन द रियलिटीज दैट वी आर फेसिंग द कॉम्प्लिकेटेड नेचर ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम दैट वी आर फेसिंग हैज बीन इग्नोर्ड। देयर हैव बीन अटेम्प्ट ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ सम ऑफ द स्पीकर्स हु स्पोक ऑन दिस बिल टू टेक अप ए पार्टिसन एटीट्यूड एन एटीट्यूड बेस्ड मोर ऑन some of the principles that were held dear by them rather than in terms of the realities before us. There is no use ignoring the fact that the desire of our constitution makers was that within 15 years since 26th January 1950 when the constitution came into force, India would be in a position to solve the problem of official language in the various parts of the country. The various points of view that were expressed then in Parliament would be taken into account by the government and by the people, and serious attempts would be made to see that some solution could be found. The bill that is before us is really an admission of our failure to solve the problem of official language. It is true that this bill does give a new life to English as the official language, and that to for an indefinite period. Why had we to do this when there was a general desire on the part of the constitution makers that on the 26th January 1965 Hindi shall be the official language? It was the wish of the constitution makers that on the 26th January 1965 Hindi should be the official language, and the wish of the constitution makers has not been fulfilled because of the fact that we are not able to make full use of the 15 years that were available to us in order to find out an acceptable solution to the problem of the official language. During these last 15 years, there has been a rapid progress of the regional languages, including Hindi, but Hindi has also developed more as a regional language than as a language which has spread throughout the length and breadth of the country and which has been made more acceptable during that period. We have to find out the reasons why it was not possible within the last 15 years to make Hindi a language acceptable to all parts of the country. Where exactly have we failed? What exactly are the reasons which have been responsible for the failure on the part both of the government and the people? This question is not something which was ignored by the country. Time and again, this question had come up for active consideration at the highest level. Commissions were appointed to go into the problem. A parliamentary committee was appointed to go into this problem, and in the innumerable discussions, seminars, meetings, and discussions, this question had come before the country. The various political parties had offered their own solutions and had advocated certain steps which ought to be taken in order to see that language became a cementing force rather than a dividing force in our country. My own party has on more than one occasion made some concrete suggestions in this matter. It was suggested that there ought to be language institutes in all the principal cities of India, wherein the various languages in the country could be studied and attempts might be made to find out how the form and shape of Hindi could be changed so that it became an acceptable language throughout the country. It was also suggested that there ought to be continuous exchange of students from one part of the country to another, specially with a view to finding out how the language problem could be solved by actual trial and error. It was suggested by us long ago that in the various universities in the country, more than one Indian language should be taught so that again a cementing force could be built up, and ultimately we may be in a position to find out how Hindi could be made a language acceptable throughout the length and breadth of the country. In spite of these various discussions, unfortunately, neither the government nor the people of this country have succeeded in finding out a solution of this very thorny problem. As long as we have not been able to find out a solution of this problem, it would be unwise to impose any language as an official language throughout the length and breadth of the country. It is not just a question of political arithmetic that there are other considerations involved. The 42% of Hindi-speaking people are living in compact and composite areas, while Hindi is not well known by the rest. If Hindi is suddenly made the sole official language, there would be certain difficulties regarding the transaction of official business. Mr. Deputy Chairman, I am entirely in sympathy with the purpose underlying the resolution moved by my honorable friend. As I see it, the resolution seeks to inquire into the causes of increase in expenditure and suggest measures for effecting economy. Sir, I do not think that there can be two opinions on the need for such a probe into the causes for the increase in civil expenditure that we are noticing. Whether the expenditure is justified or not is another matter, but somehow the country and the house have the wrong impression, and the civil expenditure has been increasing at a phenomenal rate after the launching of the 5-year plans. So, sir, to set at rest such notions that these increases are unjustified, at least the government ought to agree to look into the causes for the increase in expenditure. I agree that a commission may not be the most suitable machinery for having such a probe, a commission consisting of members of parliament, but it is immaterial what machinery is set up to investigate into the whole position. I would go to the extent of saying that government may think how best to inquire into and what machinery would be most suitable for inquiring into the rise in civil expenditure in recent years. Sir, I do not want to weary the House with facts and figures, but let me point out at the outset that the problem has to be viewed objectively. One honorable member said that, having regard to the high ideals set up by the father of the nation, the expenditure that is being incurred by the government in the name of 5-year plans is extremely high, and that we should be guided by the standards set up by Gandhiji. There was the other extreme point of view where one member urged that because we are engaged in national reconstruction, the whole administrative machinery is geared to the implementation of the plans so that there can be no distinction between plan expenditure and non-plan expenditure, and so everything is justified. That was the opposite view. We should steer clear of these two extreme views and see how far the rise in expenditure is justified by the tempo of developmental activity, how far it is a waste, and how far it could be eliminated. Sir, this problem has to be looked at from the larger perspective. From the limited point of view of reducing unnecessary expenditure, it is desirable, but there is the larger question, and it is this. We are, as the House is aware, engaged in implementing 5-year plans. During the 10th plan, there has been a very large increase in civil expenditure, as pointed out by the 92nd report of the Estimates Committee. Sir, as I said, this question has larger implications than the immediate needs of effecting economy in civil expenditure. To me, it appears that this question is intimately tied up with the question of administrative reforms. We have seen that administrative reforms are on the anvil, but the nature and extent of these reforms are not yet clear, and the House had no opportunity to discuss them.